Humanism had its roots in ancient China, in classical Greece and Rome, in Christianity, Buddhism, Judaism, Islam, and in other religious groups in other periods. It grew out of a concept of humane feelings, as opposed to violence and brutality, out of the appreciation of the beauty of art and music, and of the need to protect the weak, out of looking for answers to life and death through philosophy and logic, rather than through the supernatural and the metaphysical, a pursuit which produced a list of great men, some of them deified and some of them killed for these same stated concepts and their denial of supernatural cause and effect.
Humanism is a joyful, positive philosophy. It gives special attention to the wonders and the beauties of nature and to the creative development in the arts. It's all based on warmth, caring, and human responsibility.
Humanists believe that the Bible was written by many men about God. First in the Old Testament, with the God of the Israelites, and then later on in the New Testament, about a man called Jesus. The balance of what the New Testament offers has supposedly been said by men who were the disciples of Jesus. Now, to me, the Bible, the Old and the New Testament, represent man-made codes of behavior, some of which are noble and worthy of their humanistic intentions. Now, humanists believe that all people have the right to believe in and follow the teachings of the Bible, or the God of their choice, if they choose, just as they have the right not to.
Believing in a hereafter doesn't automatically make one a better or a more moral person. As a humanist, I believe that we should live our lives morally and ethically now, in this world, as though there were no hereafter as a reward or punishment. Yeah, I think this way we'd be much better human beings. The world would be a much better place to live in and to share with each other. Frankly, I'd rather we were judged by our deeds in the present. Maybe this way many of us wouldn't feel so free to do bad things now, as though the hereafter's a long time off. But again, as a humanist, I think that if individuals want to live their lives according to their expectations of a heaven or a hell in a future afterlife, well, that's their right. But for me, I'd rather live my life in the here and now, according to my here and now responsibilities and conscience.
I think the Ten Commandments and the Bible were attempts to provide guidelines for ethical and moral behavior for their time and are still relevant. But even if I didn't believe the Bible and the Ten Commandments were okay for our time, I would never be against the civil and religious rights of people to believe in them, nor would any other humanist.
Religion is not the basis of all governments, least of all in the United States, where the Constitution is. And our Constitution's specific call for the separation of religion and government, church and state, is the result of the experience the first settlers had with the restrictions imposed upon them by the old world's control of the state by the church. Since then, religious freedom has been the reason millions of others have immigrated to America. And it's only through this separation of religion and government that people of all faiths are assured fair and equal treatment. So, in a democracy, the absolute right to all religious freedom must not depend upon the religion of the majority, or the religion of those in power, or the religion of a very vocal evangelical minority.
I don't feel bent out of shape, but I do feel resentful when I either have to be part of invocations at non-religious government or military functions, or be embarrassed by drawing attention to myself when I choose not to take part in the prayers. I also get angry when it's taken for granted that I and everyone else there is of the same particular religion as the person who is leading the invocation, who is 9 out of 10 times a Christian minister or priest. Separation of the church from the state is guaranteed in the Constitution. And if it's not unlawful for a government agency to do this, then it certainly seems to be at least an act of arrogance and insensitivity. Incidentally, that also goes for the saying of grace imposed at both government and non-government functions.
Humanists will always fight the pressure groups who want certain books removed from schools and libraries, no matter what their declared intentions might be. We feel that parents that want to remove or burn books are not only limiting what their own children will read and learn, but what other American children will read and learn, which is clearly a violation of the other children's constitutionally guaranteed rights to free speech and free inquiry.
Humanists are neither amoral nor immoral. Humanism is a moral and ethical philosophy designed to bring out the very best in humankind, as is the humanist standard for his or her own personal behavior. Our attitude towards sex is certainly not immoral. We believe that people shouldn't exploit each other sexually. We believe that sex is a very important part of human existence and that it deserves very sensitive considerations. Sex, like religion, is a personal matter. And unless someone is victimized by it, it's a private matter and should be nobody else's business but your own.
No one has the right to the final say about abortion for me. That includes my husband, my parents, my sisters, brothers, relatives, and friends, and the government. I'll never understand how any male, or even any female stranger, can dare to assume they have the right to tell me or any other woman what to do about such a complex and personal matter. Humanists believe in family planning first as the best deterrent to abortion. But overall, we believe in the right of women to have the freedom of choice about abortion.
Humanists are staunchly committed to an open and democratic society, inclusive of the rights of all people to worship or not to worship as they please. As for morality, humanism adheres to the highest ethical ideas and teaches that whether or not an action is good or bad is to be judged by its consequences, both to the individual and society. Naturalistic humanism rejects all belief in the supernatural, including God and immortality, and holds as its supreme commitment the welfare and happiness of all humanity, according to the methods of reason, science, and democracy. We humanists desire only to improve the human condition and to protect our civil liberties and democratic freedoms, not usurp them. And we're equally against the government imposing any laws to control religion or personal morality. That's just not the government's job, as outlined in the Constitution.
Not only do I have children, but grandchildren as well. Oh, I'm a firm believer in the family, as are almost all humanists. But we believe it's in the best interest of the family and of society in general that the parents' attitudes and opinions not be forced on their children, that the children be encouraged to learn and think for themselves.
Come on, Amanda, let's go look at the duck.
Humanists have a great desire to preserve a young person's right to question and to free, unthreatened inquiry into all religious, ethical, political, and philosophical matters. We believe it's against entire societies, as well as a child's best interest, to be intimidated into becoming a rubber-stamped version of his parents or church.
Humanists believe in the value and dignity of every human being.
Humanists believe the best way to live in this complex world is with truthfulness, compassion, love, and respect of other people's rights and feelings.
Humanism recognizes that we ourselves establish the moral and ethical principles which guide our everyday life, and that we alone are responsible for our own moral and ethical behavior.
Humanists believe that democracy is the best means of running our society.
To humanists, science is the best way to explain and understand the physical world we all share.
Humanism says that human beings are part of the many life forms on this planet, not independent of them, and that we share a responsibility for all living things and the environment in which they all must live. Humanists also believe that we shape our own destinies, whatever gods there may or may not be. We don't expect a supernatural being to solve our problems or the world's.
The simplest definition I can think of is that humanism is freedom of inquiry. Humanists feel free to explore anything, to ask questions, to agree or disagree as their reason convinces them. And by the same token, humanists support the rights of others to have that same freedom of inquiry, the same right to agree or disagree, the same freedom of thought that makes freedom of religion possible.
The dictionary definition is humanism, a system or attitude, a thought, religion, or philosophy, in which human ideals and the perfection of the human personality are made central, so that the cultural and practical interests are the focus of attention, rather than theology and metaphysics.
Humanism is not against religion. There are many humanists who are religious, and there are many who are not. Humanists are just against religion being sneaked or forced into the political and educational fabric of this nation. I believe, that religion is the most fundamental choice all of us can make without connivance or pressure. All the Americans who died to preserve our democracy also died to ensure our freedom to worship or not to worship, if that's our choice, and not to be forced to belong to any one denomination.
We're against religious groups using God and other religious reasons to try to influence the outcome of an election or to pressure for legislation, and especially to try to change the Constitution. We're just as against any religious group that tries to take away the rights of other religious groups, and also against people with no religious beliefs who try to do the same thing through pressure on the government or any of its agencies. And by the way, we feel just as strongly about the government itself trying to influence or control anyone's religious beliefs.
It's very simple and very fair. We want our elected officials to work for the government, not for any religious group or denomination.
We're concerned that so many times in world history, religion has been the cause, and at times, the actual instigator of terrible wars between nations. Look at what's happening in the Middle East, for example, where religion is so much a part of politics. Think of how many wars could be prevented and how many lives saved if religion would stay out of government and politics.
Just as in ethical culture and religious humanism, many humanists regard humanism as their religion, a religion of ethics, without worship of a deity and prayer.
Many humanist organizations, including the American Humanist Association, have their own certified ministers or counselors who are legally authorized to perform weddings, act as chaplains in prisons, and all the other pastoral duties.
And to me, 20th century humanism is a moral philosophy that's appealing to people of different cultural backgrounds all over the world. It calls for the basic moral values affirming the dignity and worth of every person, of living in harmony with nature, and of helping the sick and the poor.
Values that every traditional religion contains to a greater or lesser extent. Humanism as a moral or ethical standard is appealing to Jew, Gentile, Hindu, Muslim, Buddhist, and Christian alike.
Humanism was already present and influencing the ideas and values of the Mediterranean world when Christianity began. The humanism of today and today's Judeo-Christian moral and ethical values share a common historical heritage. Humanism differs only in how it views the source of these moral and ethical values. It holds that they are determined by humans themselves rather than being handed down from mountaintops by unseen gods or supernatural sources. Actually, if you were to remove all the theological and supernatural ideas from both Judaism and Christianity, you'd have humanism remaining as the basic ethical system. These ethics and morals dictate how we deal with, behave, and live with one another in this lifetime.
It should be very obvious that as humanists, we believe that it's no longer enough just to make a small circle of love, one that's limited to self and family, but that it's in the best interests of self and family to make bigger circles until they include not only our own race, religion, country, or political philosophy, but circles big enough, strong and flexible enough to include the whole world in one human family.